Thank you for joining us for week 5 of stretch and conditioning. I am Ms. Gabe and this is Ms. Harley. And today we are gonna do a basic, like on the floor stretching. So like a mat class, yeah? Because we're kind of tired. So this is a great class for you if you wanna work on your conditioning and stretching for dance or for whatever reason, but you're not feeling super energetic like cardio. So if you want some more standing stuff, last week or week 2, 3, check those out. But this one's gonna be mostly on the floor, so nice and relaxing today. All right, so I want you to get a pillow or a block. Yeah, yoga block or a pillow, if you have one at home. We don't need these right away, but just make sure you grab one before we start. All right, so we're gonna start on a mat, if you have one, or a carpet, whatever you have at home. And with your feet in front of you, just sitting up nice and tall, we're gonna just work our feet a little bit, point and flex. Get your ankles nice and warmed up. Sitting up tall. And circling one foot out. Flexing your feet up, I want you to take your arms up to the sky. You're going to roll through your spine all the way down, arms up, and then rolling back up, sit up tall, stretch forward, and up. Hold those arms nice and strong, roll, and back, roll, and up, stretch forward, up, roll through your spine, back. One more like this, stretch, and down, roll through the spine, and back up. Now I want you to grab your pillow or your block, and put it in your hands. Hold it between your hands, yeah? Same thing, roll through your spine, and back, roll up. Now take that block, and if you can, bring it past your feet. And up, roll through. Past your feet, try not to let those legs lift up as you roll back or forward. And roll through, one more like this. Stretch forward, hold here for a minute. Now taking that block, let's say that you're not able to put the block around your toes, you can bend your knees and do the same thing with bent knees. Deep breath in, deep breath out, pull your elbows towards the floor. Hold. Put the block to the side for a minute. Taking your opposite foot, stretch behind you. Crossing that foot over, stretch that your toe in front of you. Take your feet in front of you, grab around your toes. Straight, bend the bottom leg. You're gonna grab the opposite foot again. Lift it up, go through the tunnel and around your shoulder. Should feel good. Yeah, if you're not quite there yet, you can always just work on getting this knee over your shoulder. This is kind of the key, is being able to get the knee over the shoulder. Then I hold on to my bottom foot to help support me, or I can put it on the floor, whatever's working for you. your armpits, straighten up the spine. Deep breath in again and twist. If you want to take the bind here, you can go between your legs, around your back. Stretch that leg out. If you're there, point and flex it. Lotus or not crossing your knees. Stack heel on top of knee, knee on top of heel. Deep breath in, flex the feet so you don't hurt your ankles or your knees and stretch forward, relax here. Deep breath out, walk your hands a little further forward, this should feel good. One more time, deep breath in, stretch forward. And come on up, good. Legs in front, all of that on the other side. So taking your outside of your other foot, sit up tall, stretch behind you, sit up straight in that spine. You can just feel the blood flowing in my body now. Stretching out, I feel better already. The day just got better. Flex your toes. Cross it over like before. Grab around the outside of your feet. Take this foot, slide it down, cross the ankles, grab around your feet, stretch forward. Come on up. Now you're gonna bend your bottom leg. Flex the out and grab the outside of that foot. Take this arm out to the side, then go through the tunnel behind the shoulder. Remember, if you can't go there, just working on pulling the knee over the shoulder. And then just straighten as much as you can. Good, come on out of that, cross it all the way over. Sit up tall, reach up with your right hand. Deep breath in. Twist, straighten up the spine. If you want to take the bind, go through your legs. Grab, stretch it out. Not today. Do what you can, yeah? And sorry if we're here, we can get some point and flex, yeah? Point and flex that foot. And take it down, double pigeon on this side. Stacking heel and knee together. Reach up, stretch forward. Walk your hands forward. Deep breath in, deep breath out, pulling the elbows towards the floor. One more time, deep breath in, walk a little further. And come on up, good. Now, taking this right foot out, just opening up the hips a little bit here, yeah? Taking your other foot out, try to hold your balance. Good, nice and straight in your spine. All right, just for your core, try to take your toes, touch them together, stretch it back out. Touch together, you really have to, yeah, you can't curve in your spine, you gotta find that nice balance, yeah? Three. Four. One more, five, good. Hold it here, reach the arms up, hold one, two, three, four, five. We're taking your elbow right underneath your knee and pressing that hip open. So I'm just concentrating on my right knee right now. Pushing more into the right knee. Just starting to open up the hips. Now, the other leg. Walking the foot back and just pushing that, putting more pressure on the left side. Okay, now open up into your middle split, pushing your hips forward. All right, let's point and flex our feet. If you can, lifting those heels off the floor, yeah? Rolling through, up, down, up, down. And then come here, cross your arms. Bend your elbows out, you've gone too far, yeah? Okay, hands behind your head or planted out to the side. Hold that leg there. Ready? Working the inner side. Bring it up. Out. Up. Keep it turned out. Up. Out. Up. Feel the pinky toe on your bottom leg. Rotate it down to the floor. So maintain the turn out. Two more here. One more. Hold it out to the side. Ready? Bring it into passe. Develop it back out. Into passe. Out. If you're feeling like you need more, you can always take this into a sit-up position. Add the abs. Even more. As you develop out, think about your legs squeezing towards your ribs and your ribs squeezing towards your leg. Four more. You good, heart?
Yes.
Two more. Hold it here. Grab that leg one more time. Yeah, just for funsies, if you want to try, you can grab the outside of your foot. Take your other arm through the tunnel. This is just like what we did on the floor. Try and get that knee behind your shoulder. Then you can stretch it all the way out.
Now this is nice. I can sleep like this.
You can sleep like this. Try to plant this outside arm down. Pulling your shoulders in front of your leg. Hold it here. If this is way, way, way too much, you can always just hold your leg here, it's fine. And come on down, shake it out. Other side, bring that left leg into your chest. Stretch it out, engaging the bottom leg. Pinky toe down, make sure it's right beneath you. Is that the leg?
Yes, that's the leg. This is the leg.
Plie flex. Stretch it out. Plie flex. Stretch it out. Flex. Stretch it out. Good. Now flex the foot. Grab it from the inside. Plant the other arm. And then stretch it out to the side. And only go as far as you can with that one foot. Yeah? You'll feel it where it's like, okay, that feels like my side. Extension. Engaging the bottom leg. Hold it here. Ready, let go. Point your toes. Maintaining your turnout. Lift it up. And out. Keep that leg nice and straight. Pinky toe down towards the floor on your bottom leg. Your abs should be working. No movement here in this area. Yeah, keep everything nice and still. Three more. Two. Pulling the heel towards this direction. We'll rotate. Yes. One. Now watch that hip caving. Good. Now hold it to the side. Bring it into passe. As you're in passe, don't collapse. Yeah. You should feel your turnout working here. Stretch it out, squeeze that leg up towards your ribs. Bring it in and out. Bring it in, out. If you need more, go ahead. Bring it in and out. She says, no, I'm good.
My abs are
job here. Don't tense up. Take a deep breath in, deep breath out, and then put a little pressure on your knees to push those legs a little further. Okay, ready? Working the inner thighs. We're going to bring them up slowly, slowly, slowly. At the top, crisscross. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Open them out. Pressure down. Deep breath in, deep breath out. Sink a little deeper. Ready? Bring them up. Slowly, slowly. Nice and turned out. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. You okay, heart? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And out. We're doing two more sets of this. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. Sink a little deeper. Ready? Slowly up. And go. 10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Last set. Open up. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. Sink deeper. Bring them up. They should be getting a little tired now. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Take the legs and cross them. Sorry, cross the ankle. Sorry. Cross the ankle. Keeping a 90 degree angle here. Yeah? Keep your hands behind your head. You can bring your arms up to the side. Now just tapping your toes down and back up. Down and back up. Down. Back up. Down. Should be touching here, yeah? Okay, now from here, take your block, put it between your knees, and keep them crossed, yeah? So straighten them up as high as you can now. Can you do that, Bart? Really awkward, huh?
Yeah.
Ready? Tap them down. Straighten them all the way up, because I know you can't go all the way straight. Tap them down. Pointing those toes, yes. It makes your inner thighs work in a way you don't really realize, and then all of a sudden your body just kind of starts shaking because it's working hard.
Oh, yeah. I can feel that in thighs.
So you're going like that. I need you to bend your knees and bring them a little bit closer to you. You're going out a little far. Bring it in and then back up. Two more. One more. And take the block out. Switch your ankles. Squeezing your knees tight here. Yeah? Squeeze them tight. Touch them together. Ready? Tap it down. And up. Four, Now we're gonna go up to a full cobra, so all the way up. Pressing up, press the shoulders down. So see what it feels like if you're like this. Yeah, and then you press those shoulders down, how much more you feel. Now, very subtle, I just want you to press your chest forward. So even if I turn to the side, you probably can't even see it. Yeah, but pressing right here forward, trying to get into your upper back a little bit more. It feels so and come down. Okay, good. Now, pressing up again, trying to touch one toe to your head. If you know Harley and I, we are not the flexiest in our back.
No.
We're working on it though, yeah? I'm not working on it very much. But when you're 41, you don't.
Oh, I told you.
Oh, she's doing it. And then trying to touch your other toe to your head. And then maybe both toes to your head. And coming up, rest it up for 1 minute. Coming up onto all fours, little cat cow. And come on down your belly one more time. We're going to go back to that position in a second. Go one more time on your belly, strengthening that back a little. So now you're gonna lift your block up in the sky, yeah? And then lift your legs at the same time. So we're gonna go up and down. Up and down. Up and down and up. Hold it here, open like a star. Switch hands, open, switch. The only purpose this vlog is doing is distracting you from what's actually happening. 4, 3, 2, 1, and come down. Pressing up into all fours again. Press back in your child's pose. Oh, that feels nice. Up onto your hands and knees. Take your opposite hand forward. Other foot behind, yep, there we go. Okay, bring it in, elbow touches knee. Stretch it out, lift it up. In, stretch it out, lift it up. In, out, in, out. One more, in. Out, grab your foot, stretch it up to the sky. Don't worry about your knee going out. We're dancers. Let it go out if you want. Press in your shoulder. And stretch it back out with control. Hand to the floor, bring the leg out to the side, and back.
So awkward.
Out to the side, and back. Out, back, out, back, out. Last one out and hold it there for funsies. Try to balance here. So put the other hand in the center and reach out to the side. One, try, two, three, four, and down. Then put it down. Good. Go to your chest work pose, stretch it out for a minute. Try that whole thing on the other side.
Did that reach tuck in help you with your planche?
It could, because it's strengthening your back. Yeah, it can help you with your planche. Anytime we're doing any sort of balanced pose, it's helping you with something you would balance in the center, right? Because, I mean, this position here, like, contemporary, why wouldn't we ever have to do that position standing, you know? Or just that position in general. So you have to be able to find your center no matter what, how awkward the position. Make sense? All right, let's go other side. So up on your hands and knees, and we're gonna take your opposite hand and leg forward. Make sure you're doing the other leg than you just did. There you go. And lift it up. Ready, squeeze and touch. And with control, stretch it out. Ready? The nice and awkward. Out to the side and back. Out to the side and back. Out and back. Out. Three. Two. Last one. What will help is to bring this hand to the center line of your body. Ready? Stretch it out. Hold. This one feels terrible. Four, three, two, one. And come down. Child's pose. Up on your hands and knees. Press to your down dog for a minute. I just need to get into those calves a little bit. I don't know about you. And we're going to go into a nice plank position, everyone's favorite. Okay, from your plank, I want you to tap one knee down, other knee down. Hold your shoulders. Feel those little angel wings opening up, yeah, in the back, so there's a big space. Four, three, two, one. Now, pushing straight into your up dog. So those knees are off the floor. Stretch out your back. Good, coming back up into your down dog. Walking your hands back. And roll through your spine. Okay. We're going to get into a little deeper stretch now. So, yay. We're going to start with a simple gravity against the wall here. Okay, so your gravity against the wall, and then just so we can continue working that upper body a little bit, you're going to grab your pillows or your blocks or whatever you have. You could hold two books. You could hold soda cans, weights if you have them. And while you're sitting here, opening the arms straight out and then straight up.
Try not to do this on a wood floor.
Harley says don't do this on a wood floor. It's not that cozy. And out and up. Keep going out and up. Holding here for at least 20 out and ups, yeah? And then if you have your partner to help you, pull the heels down a little further, or you can always put your one foot under a couch. How many reps do you want? I don't know. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. Okay. So, next stretch. We're going to do our bridges today. Yay. And then work on scorpions, okay? So make sure if you are a younger dancer that's not done the scorpion before, make sure you have someone spotting you if you're going to try it. But for your bridges, your three bridges right now. So working on a regular bridge. Go ahead. And if you can fall back into it or whatever, or flip into it. So regular bridge. Try to hold it there for at least six counts. Two, three, four, five, six. Rest for a minute. And then we're gonna go into a straight leg bridge. Can you turn sideways, please, hon? Again, this is not Harley and I's specialty, is back stuff. We have to work very hard at it. And push. Straighten out the knees as much as you can. So she's going to walk her hands forward so that she can get her knees straight. If you are more flexing your back, you're going to want to try to keep your arms right underneath you. Yeah.
And then
4, 5. Push those knees straight. 6. There you go. Working the upper back. Yeah. Okay. Rest that back for a minute. And your third type of bridge, you're going to press into your bridge and then trying to walk your hands and touch your ankles. Grab your ankles if you can. If you are a dancer who is incredibly flexing in your back, you want to try to grab your ankles and then straighten out your knees, which would, I know there's at least one or two of you out there that can do it, so send us a picture so I can pop it into a video, yeah? Okay, so we're doing our best walking, and you're pushing up. This gets more into the lower back. Not doing a ton of repetition with this because it can, after tons of repetition, do some damage. You're so turned up. Yeah, another thing you can work on is trying to go parallel with the feet. Harley, you go really turned out, so trying to stay a little more parallel, yeah? Okay, so now we're going to go up against the wall. This is kind of a challenging, just fun thing, but you know in our class we always kind of do some crazy little Cirque du Soleil things. Why not? Scorpion against the wall. You're going to go onto your, you can do this in a handstand. We usually do it on our forearms. Remember, these are your forearms. So if you don't want to do a scorpion and you just want to work on a forearm stand, but this is fine too. So going on your forearms, a little bit away from the wall, yeah? Don't want to be super close. At least a foot away from your wall. You can go here. Or you can go here. You're going to push your booty up to the sky. You're going to take one leg and kick up to the wall. Then I'm going to look towards the mirror as I walk my toes or slide my toes towards the mirror and try to touch my toes to my head.
This one is always hard for me.
Yeah. Now, more flexible you'll be. Yeah, that's a nice stretch right there. Now lift it out of your shoulders. Push, push, push. Okay, I got you. Head to the mirror. There. Trying to touch your toes to your head. That's it. And coming up. One foot at a time. Come down. You come down. Right? Again, if you have a partner to work with on this, your forearm, if you just want to work on your forearm stand because it's fun, yeah, same thing. Keep your distance. I like this grip. Harley does not. Mm-hmm. I like this grip. I feel more secure here. But make sure you're pressing your shoulders towards the floor. And then when I say aim to weights, I'm talking about these like lats back here, yeah? Or these, I don't know what these are called. These things back here. And I'm pressing them. Shoulder blades. Like the peak of them together, trying to press them together as if they're going to touch back there so that my shoulders are pressing down. Yeah? And then, the higher you get your booty, one leg at a time, lots of force, guess what? The wall will be there, and then just trying to hold there. Yeah? So play with that. Fun stuff. Okay. Moving on. Do some more serious stretches. All right, so let's do a over split, middle split today. Yeah, lots of hips. Okay, so we just did our gravity. You're now gonna get your pillows and put them underneath you, so you're gonna do your ninja style split. So, one on each side. Did this last week, I think, at the very end of class.
Make sure you're on a wood floor or something like that so you can slide the pillows or the blocks out.
Mm-hmm. And you, when you're in this position, you can go to your forearms. You You could put your forearms down. You can have your hands on the floor. Whatever seems to work for you. You can sit there and rock forward and back. Might get a little bit more into your hips. Breathing is the most important. I know it's hard, but try to hold there for at least a good 20 counts minimum, you know, because if you just go into something and come right out, you're not really going to feel the depth of the stretch. Good. And we'll come on out of that. All right, working on your 6 o'clocks up against the wall. So she's going to put one foot against the wall. And then other foot. Yeah, if you're more flexy, you can have, if you have an oversplit, you're gonna take your foot away from the wall more. And then sliding his toe up and then pressing back. Okay, now if you have, we've done this in a couple of classes, but if you have a chair that you want to put in front of you, or if you have your partner, you can also stretch the back out here. Then if you want, can you hold on to me? So let's say you have a chair. You can also try to bend the toe towards the head here. Yeah? Depends on what your partner can do. Keeping those hips nice and square. Straighten that leg. There we go. And coming down. If you're not quite as flexy, you may need to leave the foot. So if you're just if you're close to your splits, you'll be up here against the wall. Yeah? If you have an over split, you're gonna be walking away from the wall and then pressing back. If you're tight on the tighter side, you might need to leave this foot out just so you can get the leg onto the wall and then concentrate on just trying to straighten your knees. That's the key. Yeah, other side.
Oh boy.
Stretching you, if you see, I'm pressing on like her lower back, keep that knee nice and straight, and come on down. Or you can grab the chair and arch up, whatever you want to do there. Okay, so I'm going to give you kind of like a quirky stretch. Hopefully, you have a space at home, you can try this. If you don't have a space at home, get creative. Yeah, find a counter. I'm going to go over, put us over by this doorway over here. Boop. So, I'm going to take my, stretching the leg to the front. So I'm going to put one leg, holding here, up here, and then I'm going to push against the wall so that I can lean into my front extension here. So really you don't need this back wall, it just sort of helps you get into it, yeah? And then I can slide myself forward. Let's say you have a post in your house, like it's just a, you know, one of those posts. Take a pair of stretch bands or TheraBand and put it here and you can pull yourself closer. Yeah, if you have a partner, they can push against you here. You can do this as a side extension as well. Yeah?
Whoa.
You could do this on a counter if you want to just slide down your counter. But this is a really nice stretch. You want to try? You guys a little closer. And then she's going to switch to her side extension.
Do that?
Yeah, you feel that? Oh, look, she found a grip. Yes. Hips nice and open. Use your walls. Dancers do this stuff all the time. They use everything around them to stretch. Yeah, that's nice. Okay, switch legs.
Oh no.
We could do a double one. I'll go on the other side. You gotta hop a little closer, hon, so that you can grab the wall. So you get a little leeway here where you can bounce, deep breath in and bounce into it. Feels good, huh? Okay, turn to the side. So open those hips a bit more to the side. Mm-hmm. Watch that bottom knee or not. Hurting that bottom knee. There you go. And come out of it. Ooh. Yep, use your house. Use a tree. I was doing this on a tree outside the other day. It felt great. Okay? I want to work on your attitude back extension. So grab your books or your block. Go in your slip.
Over
straight. Sideways. Nope. Right slip. Right split, and I'm going to put it in the back. And then you're going to bend your back knee, and then we're going to put the blocks here.
Two blocks?
Yep, so that it's a nice attitude there. Now, I want you to work on making sure that this back knee is right behind you, and then I can push forward onto this hip here, okay? And hold it there. Feels good?
Yes.
Put your toes this. We're always working that. Yes. There you go.
Oh.
Oh, yeah. And we're going to switch on our side. Can you get out of it?
Yes.
Breath in, deep breath out. Breathe. And come on up. Okay. So, a little side extension, yeah, bar? Okay, so we're going to go up to the bar. If you don't have a partner doing this with you, the way you can do it is with a band to hold your leg up, or you can just put your leg onto a high counter or something like that, and then work on holding it at the end. You got to get creative, right? But we're going to show a partner stretch that you can do. So, you're going to stand in front of the person you're stretching. Again, standing in front of her. I'm grabbing her elbow, and she's grabbing my elbow. Make sure you're doing this correctly. Then, and hold your leg there for a while. Now she's gonna maintain some turnout on her bottom leg for me. Okay, I'm gonna grab her heel, and then she's gonna make sure she keeps her booty under. As I push her heel up, and then she's gonna try to hold. Let's say you don't have a partner. Go stretch on. If you have trouble turning out, it does help to plie on this leg, and then you can really rotate. Hold it, one, two straight knees, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and come down. You okay? Okay, we're gonna switch to the other leg. If you are doing this with a partner and they want to participate, then pause and let them go. We're not gonna do that because she's too little to stretch me. And I will need it anyways. And hold here and here. I'm facing the partner, grabbing her heel. Yeah? Then I'm gonna push up as I pull away. And ready, let go, hold, point your toes. She's gonna plie down just to make sure she's working all the right muscles. She's trying to get this inner thigh muscle here holding her leg rather than her quad. If your quad is working, besides straightening your knee, you're using all the wrong muscles. Now I'm gonna pull her up, up, up in this on the supporting side. Three, two, one, and come down. Shake it out, shake it. Okay. All right, let's just stretch some feet here to finish it out. I'm gonna stretch Harley's feet, but again, if you don't have someone to stretch your feet, just put your blocks underneath your toes here. Not that much, yeah? Just my toes. And then I'm gonna sit back onto my heels. Can you see this? Yeah, can you see Harley? Just toes. And then if you want, you can even go a little further forward or a little bit more. Move yourself forward. There you go. Do you feel that more or less?
More.
Yeah, and then again, you can stretch out those arches there. So spend a couple minutes there. I'm going to stretch her feet for her. So I'm holding around her ankle right here so that she's relaxed here and she's not tensing up. If you tense up in this Achilles, there's potential to hurt yourself. Yeah, you can pull something, strain something, you don't want to do that. And then I'm going to take the balls of her feet and then stretch forward. And you can handle a lot more here than your dancer, or you might think if you're like a mom or a dad stretching your kids' feet, oh my gosh, I haven't heard anything. As long as they are relaxed, you can push pretty hard. Other side, shake it out here for a minute, roll it out, grabbing around the ankle, make sure they're not tensed up, so they're not using that muscle at all, so I hold it to prevent her from using it, and then I can stretch here. Make sure you're not stretching in like a sickle, just straight down and slightly out. Anything you guys need that you're not feeling like you're getting, we're here for you. We'll see you later. Bye.
Bye-bye.